Hey guys, welcome to another Elder Scrolls Legends video. As I mentioned yesterday, today we will have a sneak peek at the first cards for the upcoming mini expansion, the Dark Brotherhood. The Dark Brotherhood expansion is coming out on April the 5th, features over 20 single player story missions that will earn you a playset of 40 completely new cards within the game. You can pre-purchase the new expansion right now for 20 bucks, or wait until release date and buy it with in-game currency. So far, a total of 6 cards have been revealed early, and I will give you a look at each, plus some thoughts on my end. We will start with the Brotherhood Slayer, a new agility unit that is costing 3 magicka, has solid stats of 3-3, and not 1, but 2 keywords. First of all, it is a prophecy unit, but on top of that, also features the new keyword Slay. The keyword might be new, but the effect is well known. Slay triggers whenever the creature destroys another creature in your turn. In the case of the Brotherhood Slayer, you will then get a completed contract. Completed contract is a zero cost spell that will provide you with 1 extra magicka the turn it is played. 1 extra magicka provided by a spell might not look too dangerous alone, but we all knew that how this one is working out and that there's a bunch of supporting cards for such a small fry available. The first big miracle might come through the Swindler's Market. The ongoing support card is dealing and healing 1 damage whenever you play a zero cost card. Decks built around zero cost cards are already kinda viable, so more options on that end is never a bad thing. Furthermore, the card should give the Lilhandra Hexmage Miracle build another nice tool at hand. And I can definitely see some great Action Assassin Swindler's Market Hexmage combo 1-turn kill decks incoming. With overall solid stats and good keywords on top of that, the Brotherhood Slayer will definitely see play. Next up is the first announced new legendary, Cicero the Betrayer, a name that speaks the truth. Cicero is a 6 cost unit with only 1-6 stats, but a new and unique effect. He not only has lethal and slay draw 2 cards, but he is the first ever creature that can attack your own minions, allowing for some interesting new possibilities. Of course, normally you want to kill opponent's creatures, but what about when you are in need of, for example, activating a last gap early effect? Killing your own Balmora Spymaster at your own discretion, plus 2 cards to draw on top, is seriously not bad. There are a bunch of options to play with Cicero, and I'm more than interested to build some decks with and around him. Our next card is the Daggers in the Dark, which is an intelligence 0 cost spell that will equip a steel dagger to a random friendly creature in each lane. You remember what I said earlier about the completed contract card, right? Yeah, 0 cost action assassin miracle 1-turn kill decks might be a very viable option in the future. The card in itself is nothing too fancy, but it is providing more than enough value to be considered in such a deck build. Steel dagger is normally costing you 1 magicka. With the Daggers in the Dark, you can create 2 for 0, so that's kinda positive value created. Unfortunately, there is a downside in form of the randomness, plus you would need at least 1 creature in each lane to get the full value of the card. Nonetheless, not a bad one, and it will see play in the right deck. Next up is the willpower card Sanctuary Raid. If you are a control or a token player, you might love this one. We are looking at another huge destruction tool. Yellow already has a bunch of viable destruction cards at hand. The best one of course is the Piercing Javelin, which is a 5 magicka card that has prophecy and allows you to kill whatever you like. The Sanctuary Raid also enables you to kill a target enemy creature, but has no prophecy and costs 2 magicka more. All in all, that sounds like a bad deal, but there's another catch to it. On top of the destruction, you are getting +1/+1 to all friendly units in the same lane. The closest companion to this card is the Allegiant Prefect, a unit that is also costing 7, can buff both lanes, but is still not seeing any serious play right now. The problem with both cards is the high price and the contrary buff effect. If you're going for a token buff deck, you are normally trying to win relatively fast and early, otherwise you will run out of steam eventually. In such a deck, buffing on turn 7 is normally too late or has too little impact on the board to be a game changer. On the other hand, the Sanctuary Raid is facing tough competition in the destruction space, and it remains to be seen if willpower control decks need even more stuff like this on top of Piercing Javelin, Manticoras, Edict of Azura and so on. Full destruction deck might be really annoying for your opponent, so someone is definitely going this route. The second to last card that was revealed was the Underworld Vigilant, a 5-cost strength unit with a lousy 4-1 in stats that has charge and also summoning effect that will get rid of all enemy covers. I'm not a fan of charge units, but this one looks like it got a very hefty price tag, so definitely alright for me. The effect is, in my opinion, not that huge, should on average affect only 1 to 2 creatures, but on the other hand is costing the card 3 extra life. The green card Cliff Racer is a non-effect charge unit for 5 Magicka and can look at 4-4 in stats, which I believe is definitely better. All in all, this one is my least favorite card, and that's why we are going as fast as possible to the last card, which is definitely more interesting. This one is another legendary with a long ass text wall. Talking about the Night Mother, which is a 2 Magicka support card with unlimited uses that will summon a small 0-1 token with guard on your opponent's side. Why should you help your enemy, you might wonder? Well, look at the rest of the text. After 20 enemy creatures have been destroyed, this game you are dealing 20 damage to your opponent, you are healing 20 back, plus you are also refilling your hand to the maximum available count, which is 10. This is by far the highest swing card ever and surely a reason to include more support destruction in your deck. The deck built around this card is useful but not necessary. Theoretically, you could just put the Night Mother in your average control deck and have another win option. Also keep in mind that you will not forced to use the activation effect. You don't have to kill 20 tokens, but every enemy creature is good, which means that you are in no need to drop guards for your opponent if you would get into disadvantage. This card is really unique and interesting, despite having a super ugly artwork. I'm looking forward to see it in action. And that is it for all the announced cards. More will be revealed closer to launch, so keep an eye on my channel with the next update. Thank you for watching and don't forget to give me feedback about the cards and the video in the comment section. A like or subscription to my channel is also never bad. Have a good day and until the next video. Bye bye.